With the recent updates to the YouTube interface from the YouTube Classic to the YouTube Studio, I feel that it is important I show you how to use the YouTube Studio to automatically create subtitles and captions for your YouTube videos. Hi, my name is David from freelancerinsights.com, where we believe you should never stop learning. If this is your first time watching my videos, or you've been around for a while and you're not yet subscribed, kindly subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification icon so that you get alerted every time I put out a tutorial just like this one. To have YouTube automatically transcribe and caption your videos, it only takes three easy steps. The first step is you need to upload your video, set the language the video is in, and then ensure that you finish by either setting the videos unlisted, private, publishing the video, or maybe premiering the video. Now, once you do this, YouTube, using Google's automatic speech recognition and machine learning, will automatically try to understand the video and automatically transcribe and caption your video. At the time of recording this video, automatic captions are available in English, Dutch, French, German, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Portuguese, Russian, and Spanish. I'm sure that they'll add more languages in future, but this is just to help you if you have videos in those languages. Now let's look at the whole process from start to finish. So the first step is to upload your video, set the language of the video, and then ensure that you select the visibility of the video. Whether the video will be private, unlisted, public, or scheduled, once you click on the finish button, this will ensure that YouTube will start automatically transcribing and creating captions or subtitles for your video. So my video is already uploading and just some few final touches, and all I'll need to do is I'll need to scroll down to a section written more options, and this section contains more options that you can tweak for your video. And for the purposes of this video, we just want to select the language our video is in. So I'll scroll to the section with the language and select English, and there are a couple of versions of English, so I'll just click on that. And from this section, if the video you are uploading onto YouTube already has subtitles or captions created from another service or by a freelancer, then you can upload the subtitles from this section. Click on Next, because all we wanted to do from that section is just to set the language so that we can tell YouTube that our video is in English. I found this to be a plus, especially when you're uploading your video, and you can set this to be ever present for your video so you don't keep doing this particular step. And then once you're done, you're going to set the visibility of your video, and for the purposes of this video, I'm going to just publish this video onto YouTube. The second step involves waiting, and depending on the length of your video, you may have to wait a long time, or you may have to just wait a couple of minutes for YouTube to automatically transcribe and caption your video. And there are some few troubleshooting issues that you should be aware of, that depending on how long your video is, the language in the video, if it's supported or not, and if the audio is of poor quality where YouTube may not automatically recognize what is being said, or if there are multiple speakers where the speech overlaps, YouTube may not be able to actually give you a clear transcript, or it may actually just ignore the automatic transcription of that particular video. So it's important for you to know that, but this process just involves waiting as YouTube does the magic in the background. In the final step, you'll need to review and make corrections to the subtitles that have been auto-generated by YouTube's automatic speech recognition engine. Now, these may be accurate, but you'll need to make some few edits so that you can repunctuate properly, capitalize some of the few words, and also make corrections to words that YouTube did not particularly get correctly. To access this particular section of the video, you go to your YouTube Studio. That is, doesn't matter whether you had logged out. And then on the left, you'll either see a videos or a content tab, depending on when you're watching this video. And also YouTube is making a couple of changes to this particular interface, so it's probably going to be on the left somewhere. Click on videos and your videos will populate to the right. If you hover over the video that you want to review the captions and subtitles to, there are a couple of icons that will appear, and all you need is just to click on the icon that looks like a pen. This is the video details icon. Now you'll need to click on the more options from this new page, and Once you do that, just scroll to the bottom or midsection of this particular page, where you'll see the original video language subtitles in CC, and you'll see that YouTube has automatically created captions. There are three dots next to this, where you can either edit the subtitles in Classic Studio, download or delete the automatic subtitles. Now, for the purposes of this video, we're going to make the edits, but you can just click on download to see what you get, and you'll get an SVG file that you can easily edit in subtitle edit. And I have tutorials on that on this channel, so you can just check them out. And for the purposes of this video, let's just click on the three drop downs and click on edit in Classic Studio. And the new page that we load will enable you to make edits and publish the automatic subtitles. And you can also download the subtitles from this section. At the moment, the subtitles are grayed out, so I'll need to click on the edit button to make this editable. And I just want to make a few corrections. And as you can see, there are a couple of keyboard shortcuts that you can utilize for this particular process. And it's important, if you're doing especially long videos, to utilize keyboard shortcuts. So I'll start off, make the change to the capitalization of the first letter, I. And then in this video, do a comma for that particular just after videos. We can just do a quick listen through as we see the changes we've made. Video, I'm going to show you how you can easily fix the mono or the one channel recording issue that comes with the Focusrite Scarlett Solo. Keep making changes and corrections to the punctuation and any errors that you might find. And once you're satisfied, click on publish edits. And the new page that we load will have English automatic and English captions. And these are the manually edited ones that you've just prepared. Once you're satisfied, just return to Studio. And that's how easy it is to use the YouTube Studio to automatically create subtitles and captions for your videos. Now, this is just a quick disclaimer for freelancers. If you're working on content from clients, I'd just like to tell you that avoid using YouTube to automatically transcribe and caption the videos unless the client has the videos and you can just download the subtitles that were automatically generated. The reason is YouTube has a new algorithm that shows something called content ID match. So if you keep uploading content from a client and the client gets to see this, then they'll know that they give you work, and all you do is just pop it on YouTube and just download the transcript or make the particular changes that you're making. So that's new, this will keep going on. So just take a note of that to avoid any issues with your client or any copyright infringements. Thank you so much for watching this short tutorial, and I hope that you've learned something. Kindly subscribe to the channel, like the video, and share it with your friends. Until next time, stay safe.